Hello and welcome to Drum Master Studio. This teaching segment will be phase two. This teaching is for my intermediate drum students who have completed phase one. Congratulations. All right, let's get started. Just like in phase one, okay, I taught a groove, a basic groove. A 4-4 timing, as we remember. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we had drum fills. Okay. The basic single crash. Okay. The double snare. Hit crash. And so on. Okay. All of those are basic drum fills. Now in the intermediate section, phase two, I'm going to teach you how to do entry level rudiments. That's what I call them. Right, left, left, right, left, left, and left, right, right, left, right, right. And now, here's how we hold the drumstick. Is strictly finger and thumbs, okay? Finger and thumbs. Okay, for my beginners, just starting off, I taught them and I let them hold the sticks with a full hand. But when we're doing effective drum rudiments, we need the finger and thumb rotation. Okay, very important. Now, when we're playing a hard groove, in the left hand, let's start with that. We hold the stick with a full hand, okay? And always, always, in the right hand, we hold the stick finger and thumb. Now for left-hand drummers, it's just the opposite. And then sometimes we have drummers that are right-handed that play left-handed. They use the left hand as the timing hand. 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, and so forth. Okay. Well now, we're going to start off with the groove. I call this the entry-level rudimental groove, and it plays like this. And so forth. Okay, now, here's where I teach my students how to interchange the grip on the left hand, okay? Now, as I stated before, when we're doing the backbeat, okay, we hold the stick with a full hand. Now, when we do a drum rudiment, okay, then I teach my students how to drop these three fingers, okay? Okay, to give an effective rudimental sound, you need to drop these three fingers, okay? When we go off of the backbeat to a drum fill. And so forth. I believe you get the point. All right. Now, let's start off with the groove, and we're going to break that down, and then we will go to the drum fills, all right? Now, the groove is broken off into three counts. 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3. Now, When I created this groove, I used the open and close hi-hat. All right. So we will open the hi-hat on each count of three. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three. Okay. So now let's break this down. All right. The first count of three, we will open the hi-hat on the bass, on the kick drum. All right, with the open hi-hat. One, two, three. Then the second part, we open up the hi-hat with the snare drum. One, two, three. All right. And then on the third part, we use the kick drum again, and we open the hi-hat on the count of three. One, two, three. Then on the fourth part, we use the snare, but we use a extra hit. One, two. And then that's when we open up the three fingers. Okay, we open them up. So it's just finger and thumb. So let's do four of the parts as review once again. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two. That's the fourth part. Okay, let's try that again. Here we are. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. See how it comes together? Here we go. Let's try it again. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one. Let's slow it down one more time. One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. Now let's put it together. Here we go. As we close with the groove section of this teaching course, remember, open the hi-hat on each count of three. All right? One, two, three, one, two, three, one, two, three, one, two. All right. Now, let's move on to the drum fills, okay? The entry-level, rudimental drum fills, okay? We're going to start with the left hand, okay? The left diddles. Diddle means twice. Or two times. Now, we open the left hand fingers, we open them up, all right, because now we're doing rudiments. And of course, at all times, we have the fingers opened up on the right hand. All right, that's where you get your speed and accuracy. All right, now let's start off with the left, right, diddle fill. I'm sorry, I reversed that. The right, left, diddle fill. Right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Here we are. Right, left, left, right, left, left. Okay, I have broken this down into different speeds, all right? And you can test yourself on these speeds, all right, With practice. Okay, with constant practice. Practice makes what? Perfect. All right, here we are. Now, when we're doing left diddles, we start off with the right hand. When we're doing right diddles, we start off with the left hand. Okay? So since we're going to do the left diddles, and that's D-I-D-D-L-E-S, diddle. Okay? All right. Let's start off with learning speed. Learning speed. And I teach my students the motion of the sticks. Okay. I say the bottom of the stick should be going in the motion of a dog wagging its tail. And the top of the stick, all right, as a windshield wiper. All right. See that? Now, if the stick is going in that motion, then you're doing it correctly, okay? A dog wagging its tail at the bottom and a windshield wiper at the top. All right, let's start off with what I call learning speed. That's broken way down. Learning speed. Here we are. Right. Left. Left. Right, left, left. Four strokes. Right, left, left. Now, we set the sticks on the pointer fingers, okay? These are our pointer fingers, all right? Let the sticks rest on the pointer fingers, and we use the thumb as a backing, okay? Okay, the next speed is slow speed, all right? Here we are. Right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Now, the next speed is, I call this, the slow, moderate speed, all right? Moderate is in the middle, but I have a slower speed than that, okay? Before we work our way up to that, to master that speed, it's a slow, moderate speed. And this speed is like this. Now, let's go to moderate speed. This is like in the middle, all right? What I teach my students, that this is the speed that they need to get to master this part of the course I teach, at least. All right, here's moderate speed. Then, when you get that mastered or have that accomplished, all right, then there's a speed faster than that. I call this fast speed. Then, one more speed, very fast speed. Now, to have this completely mastered, okay, you should be able to go from learning speed to very fast speed in a smooth, okay, rotation or in a smooth operation. Like a dripping faucet, when you first turn it on, it drips, drip, 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 and then it turns into a run. Okay? Same thing with doing drum notes. They should be very clear and distinct. Okay, not sloppy. Okay, it should be. Same thing with the right hand. Let's reverse it. Now we're going to go with the left-right diddle fill. Okay? The left-right diddle fill. Same thing. Left, right, right, left, right, right. Now, let's go back to the left hand ditto. This is going to be called the left, the right, left ditto pattern. The right, left ditto pattern. And it goes like this. I'll do it in the air. Right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left. Okay. Right, left, left, right, left, left. Right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Right, left, left, right, left, left. Right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Now, let's reverse it. Left, right, right, left, right, right, left, right, left, right, right, left, right, right. Left, right, right, left, right, right. Left, right, left, right, right, left, right, right. Once again in the air. Here we go. Left, right, right, left, right, right. Left, right, left, right, right, left, right, right. Thank you. Okay. Now let's have a little bit of fun. Let's put all four of these entry-level drum rudiment fills together, all right? The right-left diddle fill, the right-left diddle pattern, the left-right diddle fill, and the left-right diddle pattern, using the entire kit, all right? Let's try it out. Here we go. Idea, hopefully. Okay, now the next part of this exercise, this is called the right left ditto pattern groove. The right left ditto pattern groove, and it goes like this. So it's right hand, hi-hat, kick drum. Right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Okay. It's the same thing as the right, left, ditto pattern, only it's the groove. Okay, and we use the hi-hat and kick drum, the bass. Right hand, right foot, left ditto. Right, left, left, right, left, left, right, left, right, left, left, right, left, left. Okay, you can kind of play around with this. Still with the left hand diddle, we're starting with the right hand. Now the next part of this course, I will teach you how to do the right left diddle fill, hi-hat, snare, and kick drum and bass. We start off with the snare.